So, as I said, this question was just posted by Afif. This is a simple example of HP series. I have discussed this earlier. So, the basic idea, I've written it down below. I hope you can see that. So, if you have the distance constant and the traveling times are in AP, arithmetic progression, then the speeds are in harmonic progression, HP, and vice versa, because distance by speed is time, and distance by time is speed. HP series is basically something where numerator kept constant, the denominator is in AP. That is an HP series. So if the distance is kept constant and this is in AP, the speed that is, that's in AP, this is constant, then this is definitely in HP. And vice versa. So if the distance is constant again and the time is in AP, then the speed is in HP. Right, I've discussed this idea earlier as well. So let us come to this question now. What we have is this person is traveling 3 km/h faster. He reaches the destination 40 minutes earlier in that situation. And if he travels 2 km/h slower than the usual speed, then he reaches the destination 40 minutes late. Now, first of all, if you look at the times, there are three times involved here. The usual time, the earlier time, and the late time. What we know is the difference between the earlier time and the usual time is 40 minutes, and also the difference between the usual time and the late time is 40 minutes. So we can say that these three times are in HP. Sorry, these three times are in AP series because you have a constant difference, correct? And because the times are in AP, the speeds should be in HP. So what we now know is the times in this question are in AP, the three times. You have to consider three times, compare the usual time also. And hence the speeds are in HP. So that is straight away known to us. Now, coming to this problem, another thing before we get into that, what is the interesting thing about HP and how does this help us any which way? This is the reason I've mentioned this earlier. It's also in some of our videos in YouTube channel as well. So if you have the three numbers, any three numbers in HP series, so let's say A, H, and B, these three numbers are in HP. So I've indicated this as a line number, and these are the three numbers A, H, and B. In that situation, the differences, so the difference between A and H, that is indicated by this blue line, and the difference between H and B, that is indicated by this blue line, the differences will also be in the ratio A is to B. That is the interesting thing about an HP series. So if you use this idea, now what we have is let's take all of this off. Because we know the speeds are in HP, so let us look at it from the perspective of the speeds. So we have the usual speed, and we have the scenario one and scenario two, let's say. Okay, now we know that this difference in speeds, so I'm plotting the speeds here. So the difference in speeds is 3 km/h in these two scenarios. The first scenario, that is this is scenario two, and the usual speed, that is. So the difference is 3, and the difference between the usual speed and scenario two is 2 km/h. So now we know that the scenario one speed and the scenario two speed should also be in the ratio 3:2, because that is what this chart is indicating. So if the speeds are in the ratio 3:2, we also know that there's a difference of 3 here and a difference of 2 here, right? So what is the net difference between scenario 1 and scenario 2? There should be a net difference of 5 units or 5 km/h. So we get the speeds, right? 3 and 2 has a difference of 1. We have to make the difference 5. So simply 3 into 5 and 2 into 5. So these are the actual speeds, right? So we straight away get the speed, 15 kilometer per hour and 10 kilometer per hour. But also, what about the times? If we think about the times, if the speeds are in the ratio 3:2 to cover the same distance, the time should be in the ratio 2:3. And between the 2 and the 3, there's a difference of how many minutes. In one situation, he is 40 minutes late. And in the second scenario, it's 40 minutes late. And the first scenario is 40 minutes earlier. So the difference is 80 minutes between these two times. So these two times have a difference of 80 minutes. So if you think about in minutes, both of these will be multiplied by 80, right? This is a good number to deal with because 3 into 80 is 240 minutes, which is basically 4 hours, right? This is 4 whole hours. So let's deal with this value. So now what we know is in 4 hours, he can travel with a speed of 10 kilometer per hour. That is the speed. So we have speed of 10 kilometer per hour and correspondingly the time is 4 hours. So the distance that need to be covered should be 40 kilometers. So that is the answer for this question.